Hello friends, welcome back. So let us start with the C programming. In this video, we are going to cover the basic terms associated with programming. Okay, so we are going to study the general concept related to programming, and then after specifically we will study a C programming. So first concept is, what is program? Okay, the first concept is what is program? Now you can say program is collection of instruction. Program is what? It is collection of instructions. Now you can say, what is an instruction? Okay, so instead of this instruction, you can say it is collection of commands. Now what is commands? Commands are various orders that generally given to the computer. Okay, so computer can perform according to that. So now the next question is, what is the purpose of programming language? Right, we just saw what is a program. Now let's see what is the concept of programming language, or why programming languages are required. So programming language, see, as the name itself suggests, programming, it is a language. Now what is the purpose of any language? The purpose of any language is to communicate with each other. So programming languages are used to communicate with a computer. Okay, so human beings interact with a computer using programming languages, right? So programming language will allows us to, or it allows us and helps us to write a commands. And whenever we write these commands, we follow some grammatical rules, we follow some syntaxes, and all these things are defined in programming language. Okay, so first of all, we will study how to write one single instruction. Now then after, we'll see how to write a single program. Okay, and once you write a single program, then collection of that multiple program will be called as software. But definitely you have to follow some order to combine these instructions, to combine this program. Now one more term is important here while studying programming language is compiler. Now whenever we write a program, it is understandable to human beings only. Okay, because we generally write it in an English like statement. We generally write our program in English like statement, which is definitely not understandable to computer, because it is a digital electronic machine. It can understand only zeros and ones. So that's why compiler term get introduced. So what your compiler does, it actually converts your program from high level language to computer understandable language. Okay, so what is the purpose of compiler? Convert high level language to machine level language. So these terms are going to be used frequently in this video tutorial, that's why I'm clearing this. Okay, now one more term we are going to use here is error. Now what is an error? In simple language you can say error is mistake. Okay, and in programming language we generally do not use word mistake, we use error. Now the next statement we use, execution, or execute a program, or run a program. Execute a run a program. Now to execute a program or to run a program means what? If there are no error in your program, okay, your computer should follow the instructions that you wrote in your program, right? We just saw what is program. Program is collection of what? Instruction. Program is what? It is collection of instruction. So if there are no errors in your program should get run or should get execute successfully. Now when we say our program executes, what it means? execute means your computer starts following your instructions. Okay, so whenever you are going to write a program, there will be three steps. First of all, we'll write a program. Then after, your program get converted in machine level languages, in machine level language with the help of compiler. And the third thing, once there are no error, then your program get executed and you can see the output or behavior of your program. Okay, so in the next video, we will see the specific terms related to C programming. Thank you.